Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll show you through the process of getting started with a .NET MAUI Blazor application. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine, and one of the IDEs installed. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022. And click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI Blazor application. Then provide the project name and location. I'll proceed to create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the default application is ready to use. Let me show you the project structure. In the main page.xaml file, you'll notice that the BlazorWebView component, which is the root of the Blazor app. To begin with, I need to install the required Syncfusion Blazor packages. In this tutorial, I will show you Syncfusion Blazor charts with drop-down list component. So, I open the NuGet package manager. Search for Syncfusion Blazor charts. And install it. Then, I search for the Syncfusion Blazor drop-downs package. And install it. Also, install the Syncfusion Blazor themes to host the script and CSS files. After completing the installation, I navigate to the imports Razor file. Here, I include the Syncfusion Blazor charts and dropdowns namespaces, allowing me to utilize the Blazor charts and dropdown list components within the pages folder. Next, I open the MAUI program file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service inside the Create MAUI App method. Then I host the CSS and script inside the index.html file. Next, I open the index.razor file and add the charts component by replacing the default code. Within the tag, define the chart primaries axis tag to display the line series chart with the category axis. Next, I will move on to define the data source for the chart. So first, I create the sales information class. Inside this class, declare two properties, month and sales value. Then create a new list named sales to store series values. Then I define the chart series collection tag, with bound the datasource property to sales, and also bound the XName and YName properties to month and sales value. Next, I implement code for the dropdown list component by creating the model class called SelectionTypes, which has a type property to display the chart series types in the list. Then I create a list called SelectChart for the dropdown options. This will provide users with the selection of different chart types to visualize the data in different ways. Then, I define the private variable called chart with series type line and add the type property in chart series tag and bound to the created chart variable. This will enable us to dynamically update the chart type according to the user selection. If you want to know more about the Blazor charts, check the video link provided in the description below. Then I develop a method to change the chart type. This method will update the chart type variable based on the user selection from the dropdown. Finally, add the Syncfusion dropdown list to an HTML table. If you want to know more about the Blazor dropdown list component, check the video link provided in the description below. Before running the sample, make sure you have enabled the developer mode. This mode provides the necessary permissions and settings that allow you to efficiently debug and test your application during development. If you want to know more details about this, check out the documentation link provided in the description below. Finally, in the Visual Studio toolbar, select the Windows Machine button. By clicking this button, you initiate the process of building and running your application on a Windows environment. Notice that the chart and the dropdown in action. When I click the dropdown, you can see different types of charts. It is easy to switch between various chart types using the dropdown. Next, I will show you how to run the MAUI Blazor application on Android. In the toolbar option, I simply change from a Windows machine to an Android emulator and press the Android emulator button. Visual Studio will start to install the default Android SDK and Android emulator. Now, I press the Create button to display the new device window. Once the Android emulator is created, close the Android Device Manager window. Before running the app, enable hardware acceleration for a smooth and efficient experience in the Android emulator. This optimization maximizes performance and ensures optimal emulator speed. To gain a comprehensive understanding of how to enable hardware acceleration, refer to the documentation link provided in the video's description below. Once the hardware acceleration is enabled, press the created Android emulator button in the Visual Studio toolbar to build and run the app. As you can see, the chart is rendered along with the dropdown in the Android emulator of the MAUI Blazor application. Now let me summarize the key takeaways from this video. I covered how to get started with .NET MAUI Blazor app, integrate Syncfusion Blazor components into a .NET MAUI Blazor app. I also covered how to display the Blazor components on both the Windows machine and Android emulator. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.